Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
Welcome to St. Joseph's Church. We are glad that you are here to worship with us this morning. Is there anyone celebrating a birthday, anniversary, or special occasion? Some announcements. Please turn in your Lent and Rice Bowl offerings as soon as possible so that we may be forwarding the funds in a timely manner. It is most helpful to the office staff to combine all loose change and turn one check or bills for processing. Confirmation will be celebrated this Wednesday, April 27th, at Immaculate Conception. Please keep our young people in prayer as they receive the gift of the Holy Spirit. Finally, we're looking for volunteers to assist with cleanup of our church grounds on Saturday, May 14th. Please see the details on the cover of today's bulletin. Let's show our neighbors how important it is to us for us to work together to clean up and beautify our church property. Refreshments will be provided. This morning's second collection is for building maintenance. Divine mercy is like the wind, invisible but with effects that can be sensed. We may feel the lifting of a burden off our shoulders as a fresh breeze on a new day and a new chance to do good. Today on Divine Mercy Sunday, we hear John's account of the coming of the Holy Spirit. John speaks of the breath of Christ breathing a spirit upon the disciples. May we realize God's divine mercy in the clean cleansing, comforting, renewing breath of new life. This week's sanctuary candle is lit in remembrance of Father William Hayden. This morning's Mass is offered for the repose of the souls of Robert J. Niels, Sylvia DeMarco, and Dan Caffarelli. Our celebrant this morning is Father Leo. Please stand as our liturgy is about to begin.
Amen.
Amen.
The great God.
mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Signs and wonders were done among the people through the apostles. The believers were all together in Solomon's portico. None of the rest dared to join them, but the people held them in high esteem. Yet more than ever, believers were added to the Lord, great numbers of both men and women, so they even carried out to the sick in the streets and laid them in cots and mats, in order that Peter's shadow might fall on some of them as he came by. A great number of people would also gather from the towns around Jerusalem, bringing the sick and those tormented by unclean spirits, and they were all cured. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
patient endurance is on the island called Patmos because of the word of God and the testimony of Jesus. I was in the Spirit on the Lord's day, and I heard behind me a loud voice like a trumpet saying, "Write in a book what you see and send it to the seven churches." Then I turned to see whose voice it was that spoke to me, and in turning I saw seven gold lampstands, and in the midst of the lampstands I saw one like the Son of Man, clothed with a long robe, with a single sash across his chest. When I saw him, I fell at his feet as though dead, but he placed his right hand on me, saying, "Do not be afraid. I am the first and the last and the living one. I was dead, but see, I am alive forever and ever. And I have the keys of death and of Hades. Now write what you have seen, what is, and what is to take place after this." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
My hands, and bring your hand and put it into my side.
Have you come to believe because you have seen me? Blessed are those who have not seen and have believed. Now Jesus did many other signs in the presence of his disciples that are not written in this book. But these are written that you may come to believe that Jesus is the Christ, the Son of God, and that through this belief you may have life in his name. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
After a wonderful Lent and walking with the Lord, last Sunday we gathered as God's people to celebrate the greatest feast in Christianity, Easter Sunday. For if Christ were born, died on the cross, and stayed dead, by faith we'd not even be here. We wouldn't be in this church. We wouldn't be Christian. So he rose from the dead. And as he did, he came that night to the apostles. They were locked in. They were fearful. Fearful of what would happen if they would go out. Fearful whether or not their 3 years of following the Lord were really meaningful. Fearful of going back to their families after leaving them for 3 years to follow Christ. Christ comes into that room, and what does he do? He says, peace be with you. Peace be with you. And then he established the wonderful sacrament of reconciliation. Notice, he breathed on them. Receive the Holy Spirit, whose sins you forgive, they are forgiven, and whose sins you hold back, they're held back, they're retained. The institution of the sacrament of reconciliation. And then they were elated, of course, but scared. How many people have seen somebody come back from the dead? But notice, he came back with those wounds that they could see in his resurrected body. And who was missing? Good old Thomas. I love Thomas. He asked those questions that we would have asked, but were afraid to, and afraid by the other 10 apostles. But he said, when they told him that the Lord had come, I don't believe. Unless I put my hands into his side and see those wounds. Where was Thomas on Easter Sunday night? We don't know, and the Bible doesn't say so. But wherever he was, it was part God's plan called salvation history. He was meant not to be there because his disbelief was more important to us today than the belief of the other 10. We take them for granted, but here is a man who said, I want to see. Kind of like, I'm from Missouri. Show me. Show me. And so a week later, Thomas appeared, and Christ in his resurrected body didn't have to open the door. Notice, he went right through the door and stood there. Peace be with you. And to Thomas, come on, put your hands into my side and touch my wounds. You know what's interesting? St. John doesn't say whether Thomas actually touch the Lord or not, does he? He doesn't say it. Maybe he did, maybe he didn't. He didn't need to. He gave a wonderful, powerful act of faith. That beautiful prayer. I learned to say it at consecration when I was a little kid. My Lord and my God. How beautiful. How powerful. Thomas's act of faith. Give us reason to rejoice a week
pray for those people in Ukraine and those who have fled the country. Many of them, probably most of them, are Russian Orthodox. And imagine what they're going through. And today is their Easter Sunday. They need to believe. They need to say, Christ is risen. They need that hope that Easter gives to the world, to the Ukrainians, to you and me here, people all over. Some years ago, during the Vietnam War, there was an American POW, and he was being tortured by the Viet Cong. He was a nominal Christian, didn't really practice his faith very much. And one day, one of the guards of the Viet Cong knelt down in the sand and made a cross. And he said to the American prisoner, believe. He was an enemy, if you will, but he believed. And that gave faith to the American POW to be able to continue in his incarceration and the hope and the faith that he needed to survive. We need to be people of hope and people of joy. Despite all the problems in the world, all the violence, the war in Ukraine, the pandemic, whatever it is, we need to be people who can still smile and say, I'm a happy, holy person. To be a Christian and a pessimist is like a square hole. It doesn't exist. We need to show that joy. How many times in the Bible the word joy is? Take a guess. How many times in the Bible it says joy? 542 times. Somebody took the time to count. 542 times joy is mentioned in the Bible. So I guess what God wants us to do is to be joyful people amidst all the problems, that you care, that you offer them up with the sufferings of Christ. Physically, he can't suffer again, but he can suffer in terms of emotional, putting up with us and our sins and maybe our disbelief. So continue to believe, to hope, to trust. Father Gilluli was a priest of the Archdiocese of New York. He went to the same seminary I did at Dunwoody. He was ordained before me, so I didn't know him. But in one of his books, he talks about being on the subway in New York. He had his clerical clothes on, the black suit and the white collar. And across from him sat a nun, all dressed in her finery of her religious habit. He greeted her. Hi, sister. You know what? She snubbed him. Never said hi. Sat there like, you know, queen of the universe. When Father Gilluli got off the subway, a man on the subway with him got off at the stop and said, Father, I noticed that nun. She snubbed you. And she never smiles. And he said, she's a very poor advertisement for the Catholic Church. We're supposed to be happy people. And she sat there very stoically and wouldn't even say hello. So we gather today as people who say hello. Christ is risen. Keep the faith alive throughout the whole Easter season and beyond, until we meet again next year for Easter Sunday. Anybody remember Phyllis Diller? She was a character, wasn't she? You know what she said about being joyous? She said, a smile is a curve that sets everything straight. A smile is a curve that sets everything straight. so, in the name of Phyllis Diller, in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior, who said in the second reading from Revelation, I was dead, I am now alive. Christ is risen, my Lord and my God. The creed of our beautiful Catholic faith. I believe in God, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, our Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, who was of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and buried. He descended into the hell. On the third day, he rose again from the dead. He ascended into the heavens and is seated at the right hand.
Risen Lord, hear our prayer. For Pope Francis and all who lead the Church, as they bear witness to the great mercy of God during the season of resurrection and life, we pray.
Risen Lord, hear our prayer.
For the peace and mercy of risen Christ to touch people of every nation, especially Ukraine, there has been so much suffering and death. We pray. For any who feel the call of Christ to the priesthood, may their hearts and minds be open as they discern their vocation and recognize God's will. We pray. For all who worship here, to know that we will encounter Jesus in our midst, and that he will offer us healing, mercy, and love, no matter what. We pray.
Risen Lord, hear our prayer.
For those whose faith is tenuous, for those who have no community to call their own, that they may see the face of divine mercy here and find a home among us to grow in their faith. We pray.
Risen Lord, hear our prayer.
For mercy and safety for our military personnel and first responders, for healing mercy for all who are ill, for the mercy of fortitude for all who care for them.
Risen Lord, hear our prayer.
For the mercy of God to be upon those who have gone before us, especially Robert J. Meals, Sylvia DeMarco, and Dan Caffarelli, who we remember at this Eucharist. We pray.
Risen Lord, hear our prayer.
For our silent prayers and intentions.
Merciful God, you lavish upon us your gifts of faith and peace, so that we may share your Son's life with joy and love. Grant the blessings we ask of you through Jesus Christ, our risen Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you.
Save your mother, Lord.
your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with our Holy Father, Pope Francis, our Bishop Edward, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on all of us, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with her husband, Saint Joseph, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Thank you. him to St. Joseph's and actually now that he's living next door. He's your new neighbor. Welcome him and we thank God for the gift of the time. Let us now pray. And we pray, Almighty God, that our reception of this Paschal sacrament may have a continual